Yazın akşın almak ağaçlara kunduz. Yıldızlar sefinde yegane yıldız. Yazın akşın almak ağaçlara kunduz. Yıldızlar sefinde yegane yıldız.
Let's learn some phrases today while you're watching this video. As I said, assalamu alaikum. Let's repeat one more time. Assalamu alaikum. Now, if you would like to say, how are you doing? You could say both ways, formally and informally. And depending on whom you are again referring, you could say, kalaysis, if I'm talking with elderly people or with my teacher. Or some people who are working in a different places. Or if I'm talking with my peers or children, I would say kalaysan. Another way to say how are you doing is ishlaringiz yaxshimi. Again, this more formal. And if I would like to ask my friend, I would just say ishlaring yaxshimi. Ishlaring here means your work and yaxshimi means good. So now you know yaxshi is an adjective, so yaxshimi. And you can see that it's totally different, right, from English, where you only have that little adding, yaxshimi. Are you good, or your work is good, if you just translate directly, but it's how are you? If I would like to say, mana ishlarim yaxshi, I am answering to the question that I posed before, right? Ishlaram yaxshi. Rahmat. It's the same way how we say in the United States, thank you, after we replied. So if you would like to say thank you would say rahmat. Again, rahmat is not commonly used in other parts of Central Asia or in Turkey. They may say teşekkür. You can hear this word in Turkish. And people from Turkmenistan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and Tajikistan would say differently. You can hear most commonly rahmat in Uzbekistan. Usually, when I teach my class, people sneeze. It just happens that I want to wish them blessings. So I would like to say sağ bolin. Sağ bolin means bless you. You can repeat one more time. Sağ bolin. Sağ means health. Bolin means you. I wish you, right? I wish you health, so bless you. Again, if we want to ask or maybe reply that I'm not feeling well or I'm not good, or I want to just let the person know how I'm feeling today, I would just say man yaxshiman. Again, man means I, which is pronoun, it's a personal pronoun. Depending again, you may probably hear from me man and man, because I have been to Fergana Valley and then I lived in Tashkent, so I was exposed at the same time for both, so I can sometimes use man and then I can use man. So it's the same thing, it's just the dialect. Man yaxshiman or man yaxshiman, rahmat. So that means you're feeling or you're doing well. If I want to say that it wasn't a good day for me, or I'm not feeling well, I would just say bugun. You don't have to say directly like in a bugun, like today, but if you would like, you could use bugun man yaxshimasman. And this way, you're more kind of like neutral, because you don't want probably to say people how you're actually feeling. But you also want to share and to be neutral, because if it's your friend, you probably want to say that, you know, you're not feeling well and explain the reason. But if in general you just want to say that you're not feeling well, I would just say man bugün yaxshimasman. Yaxshimasman, again, you see, you can hear yaxshi, your adjectives, your word, and masman, it's already in there as negation, so that means I'm not, you're not is mas. But the thing is, in Uzbek language, is sometimes you cannot translate those endings or prefixes because they are connected to your words. So, ishlaringiz yaxshimi? I would say, mana ishlarim yaxshi. Or you could say, mana ishlarim yaxshimas. Some people use man zorman. So this is very interesting, because zor, the word zor is good and can be translated as good, but zor could be also more I would just say as a slang. So Zorman could be also, if you translate it, as I'm the best one, right? Or I'm just good, I'm Zorman. Also, you can say in a different way, O'zimni yaxshi his qilyapman. You can use your pronoun again here, or you may not use it. Man o'zimni yaxshi his qilyapman. That means I'm feeling very good or very well. And if I want to say I'm not feeling very well, I would just say man o'zimni yaxshi his qilmayapman. His qilmayapman again is your verb, and you're adding that qilmayapman. Ma is your more kind of like prefix that you're kind of trying to show your negation. I would recommend, and probably I will show you how usually I teach and what happens during my class during an hour, how and what you can learn. I use a lot of videos to kind of like show the culture traditions to my students, so they have the feelings about the culture. They're also learning about your identity, where you're coming from, how you're acting, what you're doing, but also they're learning about your culture. So one of the things I would like to show you, the video about Uzbekistan in general, just to taste so that you can see.
Baland baland tog'lari bor, jannat makon bog'lari bor. Har qadamda gullar bo'lsa, O'zbekistonim.
Also, today, as we learned how to introduce yourself, how to maybe to greet people, I would just add that usually people love drinking tea in Uzbekistan, and especially hot tea. And this is one of the common things, and I actually have here my tea because I cannot live without tea. So when people get together, or if you're a guest in some families, first thing that you're offered is tea and bread. And bread, what we, you know, love to eat, and kind of like what we used to cook, it's one of the cultural, again, right, the thing, and among the food, if you can see. So any house, any place you go in Uzbekistan, you always can see on your table bread, and it's so good. It's different from the United States and other parts, but I'm so glad to hear and see that in different states people actually are making bread. Naan, we call it naan, would be Uzbek, right? Uzbek bread is spread among here, even in the United States. And again, bread is also different in different cities, depending where you're going. Samarkand bread is totally different, even the shape, and you can actually Google and watch the video. Fergana bread, we call it kakant, which is kokon naan. It's a little bit different, and they have milk, and they add butter, and Tashkent bread is totally different. And if you go to different cities of the country, you will see that you can taste actually different bread. Now, since I said introduction, let's go back, and from today's video, I would like you to be able to introduce yourself. Mane ismim Dilnoza. My name is Dilnoza. Again, man or men. Mane ismim Dilnoza. Sim means name. If I want to ask you, smingiz nima? I'm again referring to in a respective way, and maybe I don't know the person. Ismingis nama. What is your name? And if I would like to say my name is Dilnoza, and I would like to ask the same phrase to refer to my friend, I would just say Isming nama, or to a child, Isming nama. This is more for listening part, so you may just continue repeating after me, Ismingis nama. Mane ismim Dilnoza. Qayerdansiz? Qayerdansiz? Where are you from? Man Toshkentdanman. Yoki men Toshkentdanman. Yoki means or. Sometimes you hear a lot that I'm translating directly because you want probably to know exactly what I'm saying. Man Toshkentdanman. Yoki men Toshkentdanman. If I would like to say yoshingiz nechida? Yoshingiz nechida? How old are you? You can say mani yoshim and then put your number, but you could also just say the numbers. And since we didn't learn about the numbers, we probably will continue using how old are you during the time when we learn the numbers and we can answer those questions. So again, it will be easier to learn Uzbek language since I will be using Latin alphabet to make it easier for you. But it doesn't mean that you can also use Cyrillic alphabet and learn Uzbek, because I was actually that generation kid who learned Russian and Uzbek used the alphabet in Cyrillic. So because I know how to write and read Cyrillic alphabet, like I use it using Cyrillic letters, I can read, and I don't think that it just because you know the alphabet you could speak Russian, because my parents used to speak Russian, they taught me. But I would just say I can read and write in Russian as well. So I will not make your life harder, but know that you can also learn Cyrillic alphabet and learn Uzbek language. But again, if you would like to visit Uzbekistan, you probably will see more brochures or facts or interesting advertisements on, let's say, different places that is written in Latin. So, bugün sizlarni ko'rganimdan xursandman. Today I was glad to see you. Ko'rishguncha, hayır. See you next time. Hayır, hayır means bye bye. So it was great to have you today, and I hope you enjoyed watching this video. We'll continue learning Uzbek language, and please let me know if you have any questions. So, ko'rishguncha.
Yüzün akşın alma kaşlara kunduz, yıldızlar sefinde yegane yıldız. Yüzün akşın alma kaşlara kunduz, yıldızlar sefinde yegane yıldız.